The grim discovery of Titan submersible debris on the ocean floor has shifted the focus of rescue operations to determine what caused the accident. This week, the US Coast Guard brought Titan submersible debris ashore, giving onlookers a fleeting, insufficient glimpse before it was removed for analysis. According to an expert, images of the Titan submersible's wreckage lend validity to the idea that the carbon fiber hull of the ship contributed to its catastrophic implosion. The video and pictures were examined by Jasper Graham-Jones, a Plymouth University Associate Professor of Mechanical and Marine Engineering. The carbon fiber hull most likely gave way under the intense pressure of the ocean depths, he said, even though it is impossible to draw a firm conclusion from these images alone. Another possibility is that the tiny front viewport of the ship gave way. Let's check into the details available online. The titanium structural rings that supported the submersible's structure can be seen in one image. They appear to have succeeded in doing their purpose because they are still intact. On June 18, the contentious Titan submersible operated by Ocean Gate Expeditions is thought to have imploded within hours of descending toward the Titanic's wreckage. All five of the submersible's passengers are believed to be dead. Paul White, an expert in acoustics and underwater forces at the University of Southampton in England, believes that the deep-sea forces that make expeditions like this so uncommon are likely what led to Titan's sudden demise. A total of 6,000 pounds would have been exerting pressure on every square inch of the Titanic's exterior at a depth of about 12,500 feet, where the water pressure is nearly 400 times greater than at the ocean's surface. The Titan's hull would have fractured because the pressure would have been too great for it to resist. A forensic investigation is being conducted to establish the precise timeline of what happened, and we'll thoroughly examine the remains to create a clear picture. We have information to work with in the interim thanks to pictures, the Titan's own history, and professional opinions. The submersible's design by Ocean Gate has drawn a lot of controversy over the years, particularly for its use of a carbon fiber composite hull. The majority of submersibles are made of titanium, and many deep-sea specialists expressed concern to Ocean Gate about the company employing the use of carbon fiber, which is weaker than titanium. Director James Cameron, a deep-sea explorer who has dived more than 30 times to see the Titanic wreckage, said he also believed critics were correct to warn that a carbon fiber and titanium hull would allow delamination and microscopic water ingress, leading to progressive failure over time. Guillermo's Online, a co-founder of Ocean Gate, commented on potential structural issues and a lack of oversight, saying that it was too soon to speculate about what happened to the Titan and that it was challenging to create international regulations for such deep-diving submersibles. Two titanium rings were bonded to the carbon fiber hull as part of the Titan's design. Graham-Jones noted that the rings appear to have held up. It shows that titanium was the right material to use, and linking with the composite was possibly the wrong material to use, he said. Additional research also indicates that the submersible's front viewport appears to have failed. The image depicts debris that appears to be from the ship's front viewport. Apart from the red cable that is lifting the porthole, nothing is inside it anymore. The removal of the acrylic viewport by the salvage operation to make room for the red cable wasn't impossible, but Graham-Jones argued that it wasn't likely. He claimed that they could have carried it in a bag without altering it. "It looks to me like it's failed, the window's gone," he expressed. Before the accident, experts questioned Ocean Gate's decision regarding the front view window. Former Director of Marine Operations for Ocean Gate, David Lockridge, claimed in court documents from August 2018 that the company installed a front viewport that was certified to a depth of only about 4,200 feet, or about 1,300 meters, which is much shallower than the Titanic wreckage it was designed to visit. The design may have changed between 2018 and its final mission, but it is obvious that the viewport was problematic from the beginning. According to Graham-Jones, It is unclear whether the window malfunctioned first or if another component malfunctioned and the implosion blew out the viewport. There doesn't seem to have been any large hull slaps recovered either. The most telling aspect of the video, according to Graham-Jones, was what you couldn't see. There were no major chunks of the carbon fiber hull. The material that covered the submersible's hull, which is made of carbon fiber, was found in large fragments by the investigators. However, it doesn't appear that much of the carbon fiber hull itself was discovered. It's possible that these components were not caught by the pictures and the video. Graham-Jones, however, believes it is a sign that the composite carbon fiber hull most likely failed first. According to Graham-Jones, the ship would have imploded if the windows and the hull had failed. The pressure on the hull, however, would have been slightly less intense if the front viewport had been removed first, so it would probably see bigger pieces of composite there. He suggested that it's possible the carbon fiber failed because the material had been stressed by the repeated trips, creating tiny cracks that eventually gave way. This would also explain why previous journeys by the Titan had gone off without a hitch. According to Graham-Jones, if such a failure actually occurred, you would anticipate lots of small bits of composite carbon fiber, which is consistent with the lack of big chunks in the images. Additionally, there are no carbon fiber shards attached to any other debris. According to Graham-Jones, one image depicts the tubes and piping that would have been found inside the ship. These were protected by a metal cage that was bound to the carbon fiber hull. According to Graham-Jones, in many cases, the joint should be strong enough that it goes into the carbon, and so you'd have carbon left on that piece. However, it doesn't appear that it did so. One of two things could be the case if there is no visible carbon fiber on the joints. Perhaps the joint broke. According to Graham-Jones, epoxy glue is typically used for joining, which must be applied in a dust-free environment to prevent problems. Graham-Jones, however, asserted that it is most likely further evidence that the carbon fiber hull went first, shattering into such small fragments that you wouldn't notice the remains on the joints. Graham-Jones also added that investigators will be effectively looking under a microscope at all the parts, and that would give you an idea of how it failed. Slowly but surely, investigators are uncovering the real answer. The wreckage of the ship will now be closely examined by investigators to ascertain precisely what took place. There is currently no protocol in place for handling incidents involving submersibles, so it is unclear which agency will oversee the investigation. It was particularly complicated, according to Admiral Morga, because it involved people from many different nationalities and happened in a remote area of the ocean. But the US officials stated that they would provide a report in 1 to 2 years. Did this catch your interest? Please subscribe to Weather Collapse if you want to know more and be updated on the latest news about natural calamities or disasters happening all over the world, and don't forget to like today's video. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.